Hello, my name is Scott Taylor, and I'm the Managing Director of Utilities and Public Works for the City of Tyler, and this is your November Public Works Project Update. We're at the intersection of Old Grande Road and Grande Road, and on Grande, we're beginning to perform the first steps to do a major overlay on Grande. This is part of the $3 million that are allocated annually by the Half Cent Fund for street improvements or overlay, with the council's goal of getting a pavement condition index average of 81. This is very important for us to do these types of projects. Right now, what's going on is they're doing base repairs. We've got areas that the pavement has failed, the base has failed, and so what they're doing now, they're doing the patches and they're putting finishing the topping off of the patches. They will not do the overlay during daylight on this one because of the large volume of traffic. It'll be done at night. We're trying to get this all wrapped up so they can begin this overlay. They've already been doing several streets already, but this is, again, like I said, part of a overall $3 million overlay project, and it's spread out throughout the city. We're out on the Courtney Miller drainage project that right now is a utility project. As part of the construction of putting in a new drainage system, we're having to relocate and lower some water lines. And so what's going on right now is that, and we've run into a problem upstream of here with a valve that needed to be installed. We've got some issues with the pipe size, which generally happens in older neighborhoods. You don't know exactly what size pipe it is. But even further back behind me, you'll see a bunch of concrete box culverts. And this will be installed to help improve the drainage in this area. This is one of those long-term drainage projects. Courtney Miller has been known for many, many years. We now have funding and are moving forward with it. It should alleviate a lot of flooding in the immediate area. And then again, it's also part of the long-range plan that the council's put forth is looking at drainage. We got 12 other projects that were identified in the 2015-2016 floods that are under design or under construction. We also have 6 areas that are being studied, again, to see what we can do based on recent flooding. And then long range, we're doing a comprehensive stormwater master plan.